Right now, it's made out of metal, the same kind of stuff that you would use on a bicycle frame. We could cut it when we made a mistake, and we could, you know, re-weld it, and you know, all this during the time that we were trying to get it together. So we rolled 2-inch OD aluminum, and I had to keep them, and I had this one place, and I had to rent out a bay, and I think the father thought I was nuts, and he's partly right. I expect that the future versions of this will be done in some kind of carbon fiber, some kind of an alloy, chromalloy. I'm not reinventing the wheel, I'm reinventing the bike, but I'm not reinventing the wheel.
It's 1998, and East Hampton celebrates its tricentquinquagenary. That's tricentquinquagenary year. Our town is old, 350 years being a long time by American standards. And we're small, except in the summer. Well, we know about the summer, when for a few hectic months, East Hampton becomes a fabled resort, where it seems each day we select a different traffic jam in which to spend some time. The rest of the year, things settle down to a quieter life, and East Hampton, old East Hampton, comes back again. The town of East Hampton is really made up of small communities.
What's your fitness level?
Medium-ish.
What is your fitness level?
Very poor.
What is your fitness level?
Oh, I'm in fantastic shape.
My fitness level? Hold on. I guess a 6, 7.
On a scale of 1 to 10, I'd say maybe a 5.
5?
8. 8 out of 10.
4.
Hi, I'm Jessica Simpson, and I'm here to introduce you to the SpeedFit system. So far, fitness has been measured by time and distance. SpeedFit creates a new dimension in fitness by adding speed.
It has been said there is nothing more satisfying or exhilarating for mankind than speed. What is your speed? Imagine if you had a workout system that was designed to automatically make you compete with yourself. Now that would be revolutionary.
26 months had passed since we set sail from New York. The crew was on the brink of mutiny, for I refused to attack an English ship. I was giving orders to my crew with pistols in both hands. One day I became so angry, I hurled a bucket at the seaman, William Moore. It struck him on the side of the head. He was a mutinous troublemaker. He died of his wound the following day. Everything changed after that. Somehow we had to survive, and the only way to do it was to take a ship. Soon we seized a small Dutch ship and several Moorish and Portuguese vessels off the Indian coast. Something to appease a mutinous crew.
Hi, I'm Michael Mossolino, and this is Culinary Experience. Hi, and welcome back to Culinary Experience. If you're just joining us, I'm beating my face here. I'm having so much good fun at Loaves and Fishes Cookshop making so much food. All right, so we got this going. And once we get that shrimp a little bit pink, we're gonna add our garlic to it. I don't wanna add garlic too early because it tends to get to the bottom of the pan and burn up on me. And I don't like that bitter flavor.
You should know your fish butcher as well as you know your doctor.
Yes.
Or your dentist, because they're really just as important to your health.
Yeah. Talk to your butcher, your local butcher. Mama, I'm coming home. Oh, we're back.
Look at that. That is heavenly. Isn't that beautiful? The cheese running down.
Nice, simple, easy. Okay, so we got it. In no time at all, half hour, we have a butternut squash and apple soup and a braised lamb chop. So, from a culinary experience, good food, good friends, good life, God bless. Goodbye, we'll see you next time on a culinary experience.
Thank you.
going to start talking. Like, I don't do enough talking. But I guess if you mix it up with some doing, like we're doing, then it makes sense. It comes to fruition. And so this show really, like many others, is by nature a relentless and direct and full of sweat and plenty of ideas.
Dedicated and opened in October of 1995, the Garden of Hope, located on the grounds of Southampton Hospital, was created to bring attention to the work of the South Fork Breast Health Coalition. The garden is designed for all seasons. It is a model of low maintenance, toxic-free, and self-sustaining native plants that do not require pesticides, fertilizers, or other chemicals.
What we're here for is to help each other. And I think by them participating in the Garden of Hope, it's a fun way for them to be part of our community and to help others. Some of their moms have breast cancer, their grandmas, and they're just community members. And one of the little girls, actually it was my niece, who said to me one day, who do we help next? And I just think that's what we're trying to teach the kids in our community, that what we're here for is to help each other.
Dear Gula Gogo, I'd like to see a man hammer a nail into his head.
Don't become alarmed or excited. I don't intend to blow up the studio.